Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I hope you're all doing very well. Welcome to our weekly Friday Jumu'ah khutbah, an opportunity to reconnect with a short reminder that was given by the Prophet, peace be upon him, every single Friday. The new rules are now in effect, stay-at-home orders. It doesn't mean that we lose that connection with Jumu'ah. In my khutbah last week, I talked about one quality amongst the believers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And this is taken from a fascinating passage that belongs to the 25th surah of the Quran. Today we will talk about two more qualities. So let us begin. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inu wa nastaghfiruhu wa na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu ta'ala fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu. Ya ayyuhal الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Amma ba'd. We begin as always with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by bearing witness and testifying that there is none that deserves to be unconditionally obeyed except for the one and only true creator of the heavens and the earth, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We bear witness and we testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his last and his final messenger, his slave and his perfect worshipper, and a role model for all of us until the end of days. We are talking about the 12 verses at the end of the 25th surah of the Quran, Surah Furqan. The surah contains 77 verses, but towards the end of the surah, from verses 63 to 74, in a span of 12 verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala outlines for us 8 qualities, 8 attributes, 8 characteristics that he loves dearly in his slaves. And this is a brand new year, the year 2021. And I thought that wouldn't it be amazing that we start off this brand new year with making a firm resolve and intention that I want to be from these people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. Are there some of these qualities that I can at least try to implement in my life this year? And if there are some qualities that are difficult for me, there will be others that I will find easy to do. So we talked about one such quality last week, and that was humility, that these are individuals who, when they walk on the earth, they walk with humbleness. If you haven't heard that khutbah, then I highly encourage you to go into the archives, into the playlists, and listen to that khutbah, because it's all building up. And every single week, we will pick one or two of these qualities and elaborate, expand upon them. So in verse 64, 65, and 66, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about two more qualities. Allah says, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in verse 64, وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ, that these are people who spend the night in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. They spend the night awake. Why are they awake? Is it because that they're trading on the stock market? Is it because they're watching some show? What is it that's keeping them awake at night? They're awake for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what action is keeping them awake? Sujjadan wa qiyaman. They are in prostration and they are standing up in prayer. And you know what is interesting? Let us try to unpack this ayah. The word yabituna shares the same root with the word in the Arabic language that conveys the meaning of house. So in the Arabic language, some of you may already know, house means bayt. And here in verse 64, Allah says, yabituna. The same three letters are coming again. Ba, ya, and ta. وَالَّذِينَ يَبِيتُونَ لِرَبِّهِمْ سُجَّدًا وَقِيَامًا. Meaning inside of their homes, so a number of interpretations, inside of their homes where everybody finds that comfort, right? In sleep, and you find that comfort in your, especially it's the winter time, right? It's minus temperatures outside, you've cranked up your heat, you're in your comforter and your blankets and you're super comfy. But these individuals are finding comfort in something greater than sleep. And that is the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yes, what is being alluded to is the tahajjud prayer. Now, some of us may be struggling with even the 5 daily prayers, and you may think, man, how is it possible for me to even do the tahajjud prayers? Well, good news. Start off with mastering your 5 daily prayers. Once you've mastered those, inshallah ta'ala, you will find a type of sweetness that you've never experienced before in the tahajjud prayer. I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He makes you and I from those who are regular in their tahajjud prayers. And when I say regular, I'm not saying every single night. There are people like that. MashaAllah, tabarakAllah. May Allah give them more. There are people like that in our communities, in our families, who pray tahajjud every single night. But when I say regularly, I mean if we are able to get to that point, that's great. But if you're able to pick just one night in the week and you stick to that, alhamdulillah, mission accomplished. So pick up maybe Friday nights, pick up maybe Saturday nights, the weekends, right? Or sometime during the week and try to pray tahajjud. And I guarantee you, the ladha and the sweetness you're going to feel in tahajjud, you're not going to feel anywhere else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in another place in the Quran about this quality of the believers. Allah tells us in Surah Dhariyat, Surah 51, Ayat 17 and 18. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَكَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ وَبِالْأَسْهَارِهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Dhariyat, verse 17, that the righteous are those who they spend their night in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That they sleep only a little bit. وَكَانُوا قَلِيلًا مِّنَ اللَّيْلِ مَا يَهْجَعُونَ Just a little bit they spend in sleep. وَبِالْأَسْحَارِهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ And in the early morning hours, they spend it in seeking God's forgiveness, seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. This is from the qualities of the believers. My sight is also on the clock. I've decided to make all of these episodes around 10 minutes in length so that we get an opportunity to focus on the content as opposed to a lot of information that's dumped upon us and we're like lost. Right? So my intention is that whatever is presented, you listen to that and have an opportunity to reflect upon it and most importantly, act upon it. Right? Let's move to verse 65 and verses 66, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala now tells us that these are individuals who spend their night in the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are other references in the Quran, so you know what I'm going to do? I will reserve these next two ayat for my khutbah next week, inshallah ta'ala. Let us still focus on this waking up at night. Let us look at another reference in the Quran. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us in Surah 32, Surah Sajda, verse number 16. The reason I always mention these references, my dear listeners, is so that you go back and open up a translation of the Quran and read it yourself. So in Surah Sajda, Surah 32, Ayah 16, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us and describes yet again this quality of the believers that He loves dearly. Now, if we dearly love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at least we should try, if not once a year, if not once a month, once a week, at least once in our lifetimes, right? To wake up for tahajjud and try, make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today is Friday. When there is an hour, there is a time frame on Friday where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that du'as are accepted. So make this dua today. Oh Allah, allow me to wake up for tahajjud and to worship You in tahajjud. And yes, I know there are fiqhi questions that come. Hey, what if I'm awake the entire night and it just so happens I'm awake because I'm gaming or whatever I'm doing? Can I still pray tahajjud? And there are many such fiqhi questions. Feel free to direct message me on Instagram or leave your questions in the comments. I read all of your comments. I'll be more than happy to answer those questions. Let's quickly look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in Surah Sajda, Surah 32, verse 16. Allah says, تَتَجَافَى جُنُوبُهُمْ عَنِ الْمَضَاجِعِ يَدْعُونَ رَبَّهُمْ خَوْفًا وَطَمَعًا وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that their sides forsake their beds, that the righteous, one of their qualities is that their body parts are almost like itching to get out of bed. Why? to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khawfan wa tama'a, in fear and in hope. Fear of God's punishment and hoping in His grace, in His mercy. And وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ, and the rizq that Allah has given to them, they spend from it. My dear listeners, this is a time during the COVID-19 pandemic. Families are suffering, right? In your own communities, in your own neighborhoods, make sure you reach out. Look for good charities. Look for, you know, support groups where you can band together and support these individuals with your money. Think about your musallas, think about your masajid, that they're closed, they're under lockdown. That doesn't mean that suddenly their expenditure is gone, that their salaries that they have to pay their staff have suddenly disappeared and are under lockdown. Those individuals who are serving you have families to take care of as well. So be there to spend from your wealth as well. My time is up. If whatever you heard in today's reminder benefited you, consider sharing it with all of your contacts in your social media circles. If you're not following me on my Facebook page, or you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, or you're not following me on Instagram, make sure you do all of that so that you don't miss a single reminder. And if you are financially capable, consider becoming a monthly supporter of this work by going to the Patreon page. All of the link is given in the description of this video. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has mercy upon every single one of us. Join me in making dua. I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He takes away this pandemic. We beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that those who are oppressed around the world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to their aid, that Allah makes you and I from the cause of the alleviation of the suffering of these individuals, from racialized minorities to faith groups that are being persecuted on account of their religion. We beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that those who are not well, who are hospitalized, who are going through all kinds of hardships in this dunya, whether it's familial, whether it's psychological, whether it's mental, whether it's financial, whether it's health, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala eases their difficulty for them. There are many people whom we know who have passed on to the next life. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He forgives their shortcomings, protects them from the punishment of the qabr, the punishment of the graves, fills their graves with nur, and grants them His jannat na'im. We beg Allah that those of us who are alive, that He protects us from His tests, that He protects us from the coronavirus pandemic, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes every single day of ours better than the previous, and He causes us to die in the state of Islam and to be resurrected in the state of Iman, in the blessed company of our beloved Rasul محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Until next time, take care of yourselves, and you can benefit from a number of other programs that I'm doing. All of the live stream broadcast timings and timings of those programs are mentioned in the description of this video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.